In this video, we're gonna talk about how to market a live event and, well, how you can use a live event to market your next campaign. So my first podcast, or the second podcast actually, Marketing School, we did a live event recently in downtown Los Angeles, and we had about 150 people or so attend. And it was great. Getting people to a live event is powerful because people like to talk to people. People like doing business with each other, right? Even when I have these 5-second interactions with people, they end up becoming long-term relationships. But in terms of how we marketed it, you have to think about the assets you have already, right? If you have an email list already, if you have social media channels, you got to hit your list. But you can't just email once. It's not just once and you're done. You got to have a launch sequence, right? It's, hey, this is happening. And then you have an early bird, you have a kind of middle bird, a late bird. So you have all these different tiers. And you're establishing some kind of urgency, right? Hey, like this is expiring in 5 days. This is expiring in 1 day kind of thing. So you have a launch sequence and different tiers. That way, when you establish urgency, people are more open to buying. I recommend using Eventbrite because Eventbrite allows you to collect the emails. And then what you can do afterwards with those emails is you can put it into an app called Mobilize. It can help you organize your emails into different groups and you can hit these people saying, hey, like, thanks for coming to the event, please introduce yourself. And then you're starting to build a community. And then you can hit this list whenever you want, or not even this list, this community whenever you want. And you can segment them out. For me, I have dinner segments, right? I have San Francisco, New York, Los Angeles. Then I have marketing school or live event kind of segments too. So you can use that. And I think it's free for the first 500 contacts or so. Third and final thing for right now, there's obviously other things to do. You can run ads. So running ads to your Eventbrite is good too, because we run Facebook ads. They actually allow you to promote your event. You can run Facebook ads, Twitter ads, whatever you want exactly, whatever makes the most sense to your audience, right? So you can retarget people that know your brand already and then geo-target them in a certain area. Maybe spend $250, maybe spend $500 or so. The event planning, event marketing kind of space is really difficult. For me, it's about building relationships, it's about getting people in the same spot, it's about learnings, it's about growth. You know, that first live event that we threw, we spent about $3,500. We ended up losing, at the end of the day, about $500 or so. It's really important that you have these different tiers of tickets. And it was from one of my friends, Vasil, that runs a growth marketing conference. He gave me that tip, and it was really powerful because I thought we were gonna lose maybe $1,000 or $2,000, but we ended up losing only $500. So not bad for the first event. I'm not gonna say I'm an event pro, but I've done it before. So if you're trying to throw a live event, definitely recommend that you check it out. And if you like videos like this, just hit subscribe and we'll see you in the next one.